Good morning, students. We'll start with today's lecture. In the previous class, what we have studied, that I will tell. We have started with Unit 4, Chapter 7, the study of magnetic field. In the previous class, we have seen the introduction, the relation between the magnetic flux density and the magnetic field intensity, that is B equal to mu H, right? And mu is equal to mu naught into mu R. So permeability, right? Permeability of the media. And for free space, B equal to mu naught into H, because mu r equal to 1, right? That we have seen. Then Biot-Savart law, right? So the differential magnetic field intensity, dH, right? So it is given by the current element IdL cross the unit vector directed from source point to field point divided by 4 pi r square, right? This distance is measured from source point to field point, right? IdL cross, this is Biot-Savart law. Right, the next H due to infinitely long straight conductor, right? So if the conductor is straight conductor, if it is infinite, then we came to know the formula I by 2 pi rho into A phi. This A phi indicates the direction of the rotation of the magnetic flux lines, right? And rho is the perpendicular distance, right, where your conductor is located and where we want to find out the magnetic field intensity, right? So it is the perpendicular distance, right? It may be z axis, anywhere it may be located, right? This is rho. So we should be very careful in the calculation of rho. So just I am emphasizing that. And phi is the rotation of the magnetic flux lines. Then finite length of conductor. If I take the length of the conductor as finite, then we have another formula I by 4 pi rho into sine of alpha 2 minus sine of alpha 1 into the A phi, the rotation, it will give the direction of rotation of magnetic flux lines, right? So how to calculate alpha 1, alpha 2? Sign convention we have seen, right? If alpha 1 and alpha 2 are measured above the perpendicular line, then they are positive, below it is negative, right? That we have seen. So we'll continue with that, and we'll see one more formula. There is no derivation. The magnetic field intensity H at the center of a circular conductor, right? Just we'll see the formula. And we'll be solving few numericals based on finding the magnetic field intensity due to finite and infinite length of the conductor, right? This is the circular conductor, right? So at the center, at point P, we want to find out what is the magnetic field intensity H, right? This is the formula, all right? So H, the magnetic field intensity H is equal to I by 2R into An vector, ampere meter. What is this R and what is this An? I will tell you. R is the distance, If this is the circular conductor in which I will take only the differential length of the conductor, dl, right? This is the source point and this is the field point. So this r is nothing but the distance from source point to field point. So this is r, right? Then what is this an vector? So this an vector indicates the direction of the flux lines, magnetic flux lines, right? You can observe here the current I is flowing like this, right? So what will be the direction of the magnetic flux lines, whether it will enter the PPT or leave the PPT? Use the right hand screw rule or right hand thumb rule. Yes, if I use the right hand screw rule, rotate it, right, it will be rotated. So current I will be entering the PPT here. What about the magnetic flux lines? Sorry, current I is here, the magnetic flux lines will be entering here, right? Just rotate here, rotate the screw. The advancement of the screw will indicate the direction of the current, and the rotation head will indicate the flux lines are entering this point P, right? Suppose this circular conductor, if it is located in xy plane, right? Let me take x, y, z, right? So if the circular conductor is, if it is located in the xy plane, then what about the direction? It is will be in the z direction. So an is equal to az if the circular loop is placed in the xy plane. That is the meaning of this, right? So an indicates the direction of the flux lines, that will be perpendicular to the plane containing this circular conductor, right? If any doubts, please you ask as and when it comes to you. So today we'll be solving only numericals. Determine the magnetic field intensity H at this point P2 is given in the field of 8 amps filamentary conductor directed inward from infinity to the origin on the positive x-axis, right? This is one part, and then outward to infinity along the y-axis. We'll draw the diagram so that it will be very clear. So x, y, so let me take this, So x axis, y axis and z axis. Okay. Along positive x axis, this is positive x axis. Current I, a filamentary current, is directed from infinity to the origin on the positive. It means if from infinity means it will start from infinity here like this, right? So it will move towards origin. This is the origin. So this is the conductor, right? So current I is flowing in this direction. That is equal to 8 amps. This is the conductor, right? So current I is flowing towards the origin. Then next, then outward to the infinity along y axis. Yes, it will start from origin along y axis. It will move towards infinity, right? It had come from infinity here, right? Okay, current I will be in this direction. I is equal to 8 amps. There are two conductors. This is one conductor and another conductor. This, right? Okay, it is moving towards infinity. Okay. Then we look at this point P2, 0.4, x is 0.4, y is 0.3, right? It will come here, 0.4, let me take it here, 0.3 here, okay? Let me take it here, P2, 0.4, comma 0.3, comma 0. So we want to find out what is the magnetic field intensity at this point. Okay, we will consider this as a finite length conductor because two ends are not infinite. One end is starting from infinity, but it is terminating here at the origin. So there, this is, let me call it as conductor 1. So this is conductor 1, conductor 1, and this is conductor 2. There are two conductors, right? So let me take it as finite length conductors. From infinity to origin, this is one finite length conductor. From origin to infinity, this is another finite length conductor. So finite length conductor. Okay, due to this conductor 1, we will try to calculate the magnetic field intensity at this point P2. Let me call it as H1, right? Due to this H1 vector. Due to this conductor, which is located on y-axis, let me call this as H2, the magnetic field intensity at point P2 due to this conductor lying on y-axis. Let me call it as H2, right? So I want the total magnetic field intensity, right? H is equal to H1 plus H2. So this is the total magnetic field intensity at point P2, right? So you'll find one by one. So what is the formula I will write? So if it is finite length conductor, means I by 4 pi rho into sine of alpha 2 minus sine of alpha 1 into A phi. Is that fine? Okay, this is the formula for the finite length conductor, right? Finite length conductor. Okay, so we'll calculate H1 first. Okay, I by 4 pi rho, I is given. We have to calculate alpha 1, alpha 2. We'll see. So just what I will do, just I'll draw one perpendicular line, right? So I'll draw one perpendicular line. So let me assume that this is perpendicular, right? Okay, then I have to join to the conductor. So bottom end, conductor end 1, I will take it here. Conductor end 2 is here for the first conductor. So bottom, I will be taking the conductor end 1. Top, I will be taking conductor end 2. So let me join it. So if this is infinity means it will never join. So it will continue like this. So conductor end 1 means this is alpha 1. Right? I hope you got it. With respect to conductor end 1, it is alpha 1 and it is equal to 90 degree. Obviously, it will meet at infinity, right? So I cannot join it directly to infinity. So I will take parallel to the infinity. So alpha 1 is 90 degree. But this is the perpendicular line. The angle is measured below. So it is minus 90 degree, right? Alpha 1 is negative because it is measured below this perpendicular line. Okay, we will join it to the another end here. This angle, let me call it as alpha 2. Is it fine? Okay. In order to differentiate with respect to this diagram, let me call it as alpha 1x and alpha 2x also I can call it as, because the conductor is lying on x-axis. So let me call it as alpha 1x and alpha 2x, just to differentiate, because there is another conductor to differentiate that. So since alpha 2 is measured above, so it is positive. So I want to calculate what is this, right? So we will calculate here. Okay, from here to here, what is this? It is 0.4, right? So this distance, it is 0.4, right? Okay, then I want to calculate this. So how to calculate it? Tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. This is perpendicular, 90 degree, right? So tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. So opposite is this 0.4, adjacent is how much? 0.3, this one, this length, from here to here. It is 0.3 along y-axis. So I want alpha 2 tan of alpha 2x tan theta, tan of alpha 2 opposite by adjacent. So opposite is 0.4, adjacent is 0.3. Is it correct? Because this is 90 degree, right? So tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent, 0.4 by 0.3. So we will calculate alpha 2x. If any doubts, please ask it. And it is positive because we are measuring this alpha 2 angle above this perpendicular line. So it is positive. So tan inverse of 0.4 divided by 0.3. So I am getting it as 53.130 degree. So alpha 1 is calculated, alpha 2 is calculated, and perpendicular distance we have to calculate from here to here, rho. Right? This perpendicular distance is 0.3, right? From here to here. Right? This is the perpendicular distance. So it is 0.3. So we will calculate h1. H1 is equal to I by 4 pi rho into sine of alpha 2x minus sine of alpha 1x. The same formula, just I am changing the notation, that's all. A5. Okay, let me calculate h1. So I is how much? 8 amps by 4 into pi into rho is how much? This perpendicular distance, right? So it is 3.3 into sine of alpha 2x, 53.13 degree minus sine of alpha 1 is minus 90 degree. Don't leave this minus, right? Minus 90 degree into A5. What is this A5? We will decide later. First, we will calculate H1. Right? Okay, we will calculate. So, I will calculate at a time. Sine of 53.13 minus sine of open bracket minus 90 degree. So I am calculating this, I got 1.7999 into 8, I will do into 8, into this I have calculated into 8 divided by 4 into pi into 0.3. So I am getting it as 3.8197 A5. Okay, observe here one thing. So what is this A5 we have to decide? We will calculate H2 later. So what is this A5? Observe here, the direction of current is towards positive x-axis. It is going in this direction. So use the right hand screw rule, right? So the advancement of the screw is along this x-axis in this direction, right? The rotation will be in this direction. It is going into the PPT. This point P2, where it is lying? So this is x, y, z. It is lying, see, 0.4 point, z is 0. Means this point is lying in xy plane. This point P2 is lying in xy plane. So the flux lines, it will see here. The flux line, the current means it will be like this. Just I have drawn one small, right? It will be in, sorry, it will be in this direction, downward. Right? So it will be entering here. Means it will go towards z axis, right? Right? You are getting? Just rotate the screw or use the right hand thumb rule. So it will be going into negative z axis. So the A5 is nothing but minus AZ here. A5 is nothing but minus AZ. A5 is, I hope you understood this, why it is minus AZ? Because that rotation of flux lines will be going and entering here, and it will be going in the negative z axis direction. So A5 is minus. So I will be writing minus 3.8197 AZ. I hope you got it. Yes? Okay. Or else we can leave the answer here only in terms of phi. But if it is asked, convert it into rectangular coordinates, we have to do this compulsorily, right? So similarly, we will calculate H2 by the conductor which is lying on y-axis. So H2, so same formula, I by, but we have to draw the diagram. Okay, for conductor 2, this is conductor end 1, this is conductor end 2. So let me draw the perpendicular line here, this is the perpendicular line, right? So this is 90 degree here. Right, so just rotate it so that it is below and above, right? So conductor end 1 is below and conductor end 2 is above, because it is like this. So this is below and this is above. Just rotate it so that you will come to know. So we will calculate the angle, right? This is the perpendicular line. Okay, this angle we have to measure from perpendicular line. So this is alpha 1 y, right? So this I have to join this end, but this will never join, so this will be perpendicular. So this angle is alpha to y. So this is below and above, right? One is below, this is above, means alpha 2, it is 90 degree, plus 90 degree. And alpha 1 y, whatever we calculate, it is negative, right? It is below. So we'll calculate alpha 1 y. So tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. So this is opposite. How much is this? Y is 0.3. Opposite by adjacent. This one, this distance is 0.4. So we'll calculate alpha 1 y, tan of alpha 1 y. It is equal to opposite by adjacent. So opposite is 0.3, adjacent is 0.4, 0.3 by 0.4. So we'll calculate, which implies alpha 1 y is equal to tan inverse of 0.3 divided by 0.4. So I'm getting it as 36.869 degrees. But this is negative because alpha 1 y we are measuring below. Below means negative. So alpha 1, which implies alpha 1 y is equal to minus 36.869 degree. You can write the reason, because angle is measured below. Angle is measured below. So it is negative, right? Okay. The next, okay, we came to know what is alpha 1 y. Alpha 2 y, it is there. Alpha 2 y is how much? It is 90 degree. Alpha 2 y is plus 90 degree. So we came to know alpha 2 y, alpha 1 y. So we'll use this formula. H2 vector is equal to I is how much? A times by 4 pi rho. 4 into pi into rho is how much? The perpendicular distance. This here to here, it is 0.4. 0.4 into sine of alpha 2. Alpha 2 is 90 degree. Minus sine of alpha 1. Alpha 1 is minus 36.869 degree into A5. Now observe this once again. What is A5? We will decide. Use the right hand thumb rule, right? So once again, it will be in the same direction. A5 is equal to minus AZ only. So I will write A5 is equal to minus AZ. Okay, we'll substitute minus AZ later. So we'll calculate this first. So I'll calculate sine of 90 degree minus sine of minus 36.869. So into 8 divided by 4 into pi into 0.4. So I'm getting it as 2.546 A5. But what is A5? We'll substitute here. It is equal to minus 2.546 AZ. Right? So total H is equal to H1 plus H2. Right? Okay. What is H1? So minus 3.8197. 97 AZ. Then what about this? Minus 2.546 AZ, H2, right? So total H, the total magnetic field intensity at this point P2, let me call it as H2 or simply H only, no problem, right? So minus 3.8197 minus 2.546. So I'm getting it as minus 6.3657 AZ. Right? If it is asked to express in 5 only, means this is AFI equal to minus AZ, right? So simply plus 6.3657 AFI I can write. Is it fine? I hope you are not getting confused. Right? So this is in rectangular coordinates. Let me verify the answer. It is in the next slide. So you can see here. H1 is minus 3.819, right? Minus 3 point. And H2 is minus 2.546. And this one is minus 6.3565 AZ. Is it fine? If we express in terms of AFI also, no problem. But it is asked to find express in rectangular coordinates, means compulsorily it should be in AX, AY, AZ. Right? This is minus. Any doubts? Okay. This is the answer for the previous problem already solved. Next. This one we have solved. but I'll be part A, part B, part this similar type using Biot-Savart law, right? Let me read the question. Given the following values of P1 and P2, what is this P1 and P2? P1 is source point, P2 is field point, where we want to find out magnetic field intensity, and I1 delta L1, this is current element. Calculate delta H2. P1, P2 is given, and this is I1 delta L1 is given. This type we have done. So part B, same thing. So let me take up part C, right? Part C I will do. Part A, part B, I am leaving it to you people. So let me take up part C. So, yes, let me, what is this? Point P1 is 1, 2, 3. This is the source point, which is generating the magnetic field lines. P2 is minus 3, minus 1, 2. This is the field point where we want to find out magnetic field intensity. Then I1 delta L1 is given. I1 delta L1 vector, actually it should be vector, right? So it is nothing but 2 pi minus ax plus ay plus 2az. Micro means 10 power minus 6 micro amp meter. Part A and part B is very easy, actually only az component is there. But here you can check AX, AY, AZ, three components are there. So I am taking part C, right? Part AB, A is already done almost in the first lecture of this chapter, similar to that. Okay, try it out. Okay, let me, okay, this is given. Then what is Biot-Savart law? We want to find out the magnetic field intensity delta H2 or DH2, whatever it is, DH2 or delta H2, one and the same. Is it fine? So it is equal to IDL cross AR divided by 4 pi R square. Okay, IDL 1, current element 1, right? I1, let me call it as I1, DL 1, delta L1. AR 1 to 2, so R 1 to 2, right? We'll find out these things. Okay, what is R 1 to? We'll find out. I1 DL 1 is given. AR 1 to, what is R 1 to? So this is 1 to 2. So minus 3, minus 1, minus 4ax, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3ay, 2, minus 3, 2 minus 3 means minus 1, so minus az. I hope you are getting, is it fine? So this is R12. So if I want magnitude of R12, we will calculate under root of 4 square plus 3 square plus 1 square. Under root of 4 square plus 3 square plus 1 square, right? So we are getting it as 5.099. And we will calculate AR12 also. So AR12, the vector R12 divided by its magnitude. So we will divide and write it. The vector R12 divided by its magnitude, right? So 4 divided by 5.099, so minus 0.7844 AX. Then divide minus 3 by 5.0, 3 divided by, so 3 divided by 5.099, so I am getting it as minus 0.5883 AY. Then 1 divided by 5 point this, 1 divided by 5.099. So all are minus only here. So yes, all are minus only here, yes. Minus 0.1961 AZ. So this is AR12. So we'll substitute here and we'll calculate del H2 or DH2, whatever it is, right? DH2 is equal to, what is I1 DL1? It is given. So you will multiply 2 pi for this and write it 2 into pi. So 2 into pi is how much? Right? 2 into pi. It is 6.283. So you will multiply 2 pi and write it. Minus 6.283 AX. So next multiply 2 pi for this. Plus 6.283 AY. Then multiply 2 pi for 2 pi into 2. So I am getting 12.566 AZ. into 10 power minus 6. This is I1, okay, let me, I1 delta L1. After multiplication, I have written here, 10 power minus 6 amp meter. Okay, I have I1 delta L1, I have AR12 here. So I have to take the cross product of I1 DL1 cross AR12. We will take the cross product of I1 DL1 cross, then we will divide it, right? So I1 DL1 cross, I1 DL1 cross AR12. So this is given in Cartesian system. So it is AX, AY, AZ. Then next, what is this I1 DL1? So components of x, y, z. So minus 6.283, minus 6.283, plus 6.283. It is y component. Then z component is 12.566, 12.566. 10 power minus 6, I will take it outside. This you should not leave it. Then next, AR12, the components of x, y, z. Component of x is minus 0.7844, minus 0.7844. Then next, minus 0.5883. Then next, minus this is point or 1961. Let me check it. 1 by means 0.19, I think, right? Please let me check it once again. 1 divided by 5.099. So it is 0.19. You people also not told. So this is 0.19. So minus 0.1961. So 10 power minus 6 is there. I'll take it here. Okay. So we'll solve it. If I am going wrong, please correct me. So I'll multiply this into this, right? Okay. I'll multiply and write it directly. 6.283 into minus 0.1961. Close bracket. Then minus of open bracket minus 0.5883 into 12.566. I have calculated at a stretch and I am writing here, so I am getting it as 6.1604. If I am doing wrong, please correct me. Minus AY into, I'll leave this column, leave this row, this into this I have to multiply, so I will multiply minus 6.283 into minus 0.1961, close bracket, minus of open bracket. Then I will multiply these two, minus of these two, minus 0.7844 into 12.566. So I am getting it as 10.4605 plus AZ into, so leave this column, leave this row, this I have to multiply, so open bracket, minus 6.283 into minus 0.5883, close bracket, minus open bracket. So this I have done. Next I will be doing this, right? So minus 0.7844 into 6.283. So I am getting it as 8.6246. This entire thing into 10 power minus 6. I should not leave this 10 power minus 6. Right? So this is I1 DL1 cross AR12. Right, so we will find out, divide by 4 pi r square, this is 4 pi, so 4 pi r square, right? So dh2 is equal to, so I will rewrite this, 6.1604 ax, this is plus or minus, plus only, right? Yes, minus 10 point, if anything is wrong, please let me know it, don't wait till the end. plus 8.6246 az into 10 power minus 6. This is id1, i1 dl1 cross ar1. This divided by 4 pi r12 square divided by 4 into pi into r12. What is r12? It is 5.099 square r12 square. So we will calculate dh2. Yes, so 6.1604 divided by this entire thing. So let me calculate the denominator. How much I will get? 4 into pi into 5.099 square. So I am getting this below part as this one as 326.723. So I will divide and write. So 6.1604 divided by 326. 326.723. So let me take alpha a divided by 326.723. Calculate. So a value is 6.1604. So I am getting it as 0.0188 ax. Minus. So next 10.4605 divided by 326. So I am getting it as 0.0320 AY. Then plus 8.6246. So I am getting it as 0.02639 AZ. Into 10 power minus 6. So ampere meter, right? Let me check. Yes, they have expressed in terms of nano. Nano means 10 power minus 9. If I express in terms of, it is micro. So nano means 3 digits front, right? So 10 power minus 6. So 18.89. It's correct. Then 1, 2, 3, 32 something, 32.0. Here 33 they are getting, no problem, right? So 1, 2, 3, 26.39. Yes, we are getting this. They expressed in terms of nano, but I expressed in terms of micro. You can keep it or else you can express in terms of nano ampere meter. Is it fine? So part A and B, you do it. Part A answer is given here. This is part A. Then part B, right? You do it. Okay, we'll take up the next problem. Yes, 1 minute. Yes, a current filament carrying 15 amps in the AZ direction. Yes, current carrying conductor is in the AZ direction, right? The magnitude of current is 15 amps in the AZ direction, lies along the entire Z axis, means along entire Z axis means from minus infinity to plus infinity along entire Z axis. Find H in rectangular coordinates at this point, they have asked. And this is part B, another point they have given. You will see one by one, right? So let me draw it here. Coordinate axis, X axis, Y axis, and Z axis. So current filament is along entire Z axis. So entire Z axis means it is varying from minus infinity to plus infinity. Right, let me start from dot, right, minus infinity to plus infinity. This is the conductor lying along Z, and current I, where it is flowing in the AZ direction, right? So current I is flowing here, I is equal to 15 amps in AZ direction, along Z direction, AZ, right? So it is flowing in the upward AZ direction. Then find H at this point, PA. We will look at this point, part A will take it, root 20, X is root 20, somewhere it will come. Y is 0, Z is 4. Somewhere it will come here, right? Is it fine? So this point will come here. PA of root 20, comma 0, comma 4. Okay, one more thing they asked. Find H in rectangular coordinates. Means if you are getting answer in terms of FI, you should convert it into AX, AY, AZ, right? Rectangular coordinates they have asked, right? Okay. This is the scenario. We'll first part A will take up. So PA of root 20 comma 0 comma 4. So where this point is lying actually? X and Z means this point is lying in XZ plane. XZ plane. Why this is required, I will tell you. Let me identify that this point is lying in XZ plane, right? It is very much clear. Okay. Current I is flowing in AZ direction, in the upward direction like this. Okay, this is infinite conductor. We know the formula for infinite conductor. H due to infinite conductor is given by I by 2 pi rho into Fi. See here, this is in Fi, but they want H in rectangular coordinates. But let me first get the answer in Fi, then we will convert it, right? Okay, I we know. What is rho? It is the perpendicular distance. So this is the perpendicular distance. So this is the perpendicular distance. So what is this perpendicular distance? Z is 4 means, right? It will be 4, right? Rho, what is this value actually from here to here? So totally it should move. X is root 20. So this is the perpendicular distance means root 20. This is root 20 from here to here. Is it fine? So this is rho, perpendicular distance. Is it fine? So we'll substitute H vector is equal to I is how much? 15 amps divided by 2 into pi into rho is how much? Root 20. Or else if you want to calculate, you can this, what are the coordinates of this point? Root 20, 0, 4, right? So what are the coordinates here on Z axis? On Z axis, X is 0, Y is 0. What about Z? It is same as this. If you calculate the distance, once again, it will get the same answer, I think. Just let me check it. Right, from this is the source point and this is the field point, right? Source point to field point. So root 20 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 4 minus means root 20 only I am getting rho. Is it fine? If you take two points and calculate the distance, it will be same, root 20 only. So root 20 into a phi. So I'll calculate this. 15 divided by 2 into pi into root 20. Close bracket. So I am getting it as 0.53 5, 5338 A5. Okay, this is fine. But they asked to calculate in rectangular coordinates. Observe here, this point is lying here. I want to find out magnetic field. Already we have found out. So current I, use the right hand thumb rule, right? If you use the right hand thumb rule, the magnetic field intensity is leaving this because this point PA is lying in XZ plane. This is XZ plane, right? So this is XZ plane. So the flux line will come out and it will go towards y axis, right? Flux line, the folded fingers, right? So current I, the thumb will point in the direction of flow of current. The folded fingers means it will cross and it will go towards y. Means Fi is nothing but Ay here because it is moving towards positive Ay axis. So no need to convert, but just by looking at the point, we can say 5338 Ay vector ampere meter. Is it fine? So 0.534 Fi ampere, just by looking at the location. But in the part B it is not like that. We'll see it there, right? So or else you know H vector. This is in cylindrical system. This is H rho. You know how to convert H rho to H Cartesian. You know the procedure. This is given H rho, right? It is in Cartesian system. Sorry, cylindrical coordinate system. H cylindrical. CYL. H cylindrical. H Cartesian. You know how to convert from cylindrical to Cartesian. You can use this. But since the point is located in the XZ plane, the magnetic flux lines will enter behind the XZ plane and they will go in the direction of positive Y axis. So Fi is nothing but Ay. Just by looking at this diagram I have written here. If you convert, you will get the same answer. Is it fine? But for part B, you have to convert. We'll see there for part B. So part B, PB of 2 comma minus 4 comma plus 4. Okay, the same diagram. I will redraw it once again. X axis, Y axis, Z axis. So conductor is lying on the entire Z axis. It is from minus infinity and it is going towards plus infinity. Right, this is the conductor. Let me locate this point. X is 2. And y is minus 4, right? So negative y axis also I will draw. right? X is 2, y is minus 4, and z is 4, right? Let me draw it here. Is it fine? Let me take it here. PB of 2 comma minus 4 comma 4. See here, this point P is not located in xz plane as compared to the part A, right? It is in the three dimensional space. So now it is very difficult to find out that A5. So that we'll see, we'll convert it. That's all. Okay, draw the perpendicular distance. Draw the perpendicular distance. Right? So what are the coordinates of this point? So x is 0, y is 0. What about z? Height should be same as this. So it is 4 only. Right? So this is source point and this is field point. So this distance is rho from here to here. Is it fine? Here to here. Okay, we'll calculate that later. So since what is h vector due to this infinite conductor, I by 2 pi rho into a phi, we know this. So we'll calculate this distance vector first, right? So source point to field point. So let me call it as rho instead of rho, I'll call it as r here, r vector, let me find out. So source point to field point, 2 minus 0, 2ax, minus 4, minus 0, minus 4ay. 4 minus 4, z component is absent. So calculate r. This is nothing but rho. This r, right? R is nothing but rho. The distance between source point to field point. Perpendicular distance. This is perpendicular distance, right? So rho is equal to under root of 2 square plus 4 square. Root of 2 square plus 4 square. So I am getting it as 4.472. So let me substitute and calculate. So I is how much? Current I. It is 15 amps, I think. Yes, it is given. And it is flowing in the AZ direction. Yes, same, 15 amps. So 15 divided by 2 into pi into rho is how much? 4.472 into AFI. Actually, answer is over, but they have asked to find out in rectangular coordinates. So in terms of AFI, we should convert it to rectangular system. We know how to convert. 15 divided by 2 into pi into 4.472. So I am getting it as 0.5338 A5. But this is in cylindrical system, H cylindrical. But convert it into H Cartesian. You know how to convert. I hope you will do it. This is the given vector is in cylindrical. You know, in first chapter we have studied in vector analysis. Cylindrical to H Cartesian. HX into AX plus HY into AY, you write it like this, right? Plus HZ into AZ. Just I will give the hint, that's all. Call this as equation 1 and find out HX. How to find out HX? HX is equal to H cylindrical into AX. This is H cylindrical into AX. You calculate, you will get something. Similarly, you calculate HY. HY is equal to H cylindrical into AY. H cylindrical into AY. So you calculate, you will get something. Similarly, you calculate HZ and substitute HX, HY, HZ. So finally, I will get H Cartesian is equal to, I will write the answer, whatever I am getting here. Yes, 0.477 AX, 0.477 AX plus 0.239 AY, ampere meter. You check it. You know the conversion, so I am leaving that. So directly I have written the answer. Right? Ampere meter. Is it fine? Okay. This is okay. I can solve this problem also. Still time is there. I hope you got it. Or else you can leave the answer here only. But they have asked, find the H in rectangular coordinates. Right? If it is not asked, directly you can leave the answer here itself. Is it fine? Okay, we'll take up this. This is the last problem of today's class. Find the magnetic flux density at the center O of a square. This should be center O. Okay, or else you make it P. Because in the diagram it is P. At the center P of a square of sides equal to 5 meter and carrying 10 amps of current. This is the diagram given, right? A. This is the current element. A to B, B to C, C to D, D to A. Right, so A to B it is 5 meters, B to C is 5 meters, C to D 5 meters, D to A 5 meters. But it is at the center means, so in between. So this From here to here it is 2.5, here to here it is 2.5, right? 2.5, 2.5, everywhere, same, okay? Okay, point P, where we want to find out the magnetic field intensity. So let me take this as one conductor, right? BC is one conductor, CD is another conductor, D to A is another conductor, A to B is another conductor. There are four different conductors are there, right? Let me take this conductor B to C, right? So this is the point P. Draw the perpendicular line here. This is 90 degree. So finite length conductor, conductor end 1 is here, conductor end 2 is here, right? So measure the angle below, this is alpha 1, measure the angle above this per alpha 2. So we'll calculate alpha 1, alpha 2, right? But observe here, since if I calculate for BC, next I should go for CD. So once again, I should draw the perpendicular line here. This is 90 degree. So this is these angles. Observe here, right? So above and below, this is below alpha 1 and this is above alpha 2. Just rotate it so that this is below and above. So but since this is a square, so if I calculate for one side, that is sufficient. Just observe by right hand thumb rule for B to C. So keep your thumb reverse thumbs up shape. So the thumb will indicate the direction of flow of current. But what is the rotation of flux? The flux will come out of this point P. It will come out of this PPT. It will come out at point P at this PPT. Similarly, you take CD, check it. Once again, it will come out here. If you take DA, direction of current is in the upward direction, it will come out. So if I calculate for one, that is sufficient. So we will calculate only for one, right? So for finite length conductor, H vector is equal to I by, we should be knowing the formula, I by 4 pi rho into sine of alpha 2 minus sine of alpha 1 into A phi. Okay, let me calculate this as H1 due to this conductor B to C, the field intensity at point P as H1. Let me call it as H1 vector due to this BC, right? So due to BC, section BC or conductor BC. So we will calculate H1 at point P, so that this will be very clear. Is it fine? Okay, I is given 10 amps, right? So rho, perpendicular distance from here to here, what is this distance? It is 2.5, rho is 2.5. Then alpha 1, what is alpha 1, alpha 2? No need to calculate, tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent, you can calculate. But since this is a square, so totally it will be 90 degree, so 45 degree, 45 degree. So alpha 1 is below, so alpha 1 is minus because it is negative, it is measured below. So minus 45 degree, then what about alpha 2? It is plus 45 degree. Because it is measured above. If you calculate tan of alpha 1 equal to opposite by adjacent, you can do that. Tan of alpha 1 equal to opposite is 2.5, sorry, this is 90 degree, opposite by adjacent, this is 2.5, tan inverse of 1, it is 45 only, right? Okay. So you calculate H1. So I is how much? 10 amps into 4 into pi into rho is 2.5, sine of alpha 2, 45 degree. Minus sine of alpha 1 minus 45 degree into A phi. Okay, we'll calculate H1, how much you will get. So is it fine? So we'll calculate this. Sine of 45 minus sine of minus 45. Yes, I got something 1.414 into 10 divided by 4 into pi into 2.5. So I am getting this entire thing as 0.450 A5. They have not asked anything to calculate H vector in rectangular coordinates. H vector in rectangular coordinates means, so let me check it. Observe here, x axis is here, y axis is here. If I consider the point P, it is going towards z direction. So A5 is nothing but AZ here. I can identify. A5 is nothing but AZ. Let me express answer in both, right? So due to conductor BC is over. Similarly, the H2 due to conductor CD, and similarly H3 due to conductor DA, then H4 we have to calculate, so due to conductor AB. right? So, but here H1 is equal to H2 is equal to H3, because it will be same, the magnetic field intensity. It is equal to H4, so it is nothing but, let me call it as H, right? Or else simply write H. Okay. Then I want the total magnetic field intensity at point P. Total magnetic field intensity, at point P is given by H total. Let me call it as H total. It is equal to 4 times H, because H1 plus, right? 4 times H, or else for H1 plus H2 plus H3 you can do, or else 4 times H, one and the same. So H is 4 times H, H is equal to 0.450A5. So let me multiply 4 times of 4 into 0.450A5. So 4 into 0.450. So I am getting it as 1.8A5 ampere meter. I hope you got this. So if it is asked in rectangular coordinates, what you have to write? H total is equal to, it is not asked here. Okay, something happened. Okay. H total is equal to, what is AFI? It is equal to AZ. Just you write 1.8 AZ, that's all. AZ ampere meter. This is in cylindrical, this is in rectangular coordinate system. Alright. So the solution is there here. So you can, they are given in rectangular. So 1.8 AZ. So we have got it, right? 1.8 AZ. So we will wind up the today's session here. Stop recording.